Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, a free site, digitalassetlife.com, a free site. It is Sunday, September 19th, 2021. Now, I've made videos here online talking about how in the cryptoverse, there are two groups. There's Bitcoin, and then there's everything else, right? I'm not a Bitcoin maximalist. I'm invested in a lot of the altcoins. But as I've said here repeatedly, if there's one cryptocurrency that I was limited to investing in, it would be Bitcoin, right? As Michael Saylor has pointed out, Bitcoin is industrial grade. It's institutional grade, right? Let me make a more substantial point here. There's a huge difference between Bitcoin and most of the other coins. Right now, you need to be aware of this difference, especially since we live in a world where there is a conflict between cryptocurrencies and the plans of sovereign nations. Right? You have China right now banning cryptocurrencies, shutting down miners, right? Just understand, cryptocurrencies and sovereign states that want to control their money supply are on a collision course. With Bitcoin, you have proof of work. Understand, it's decentralized, right? There's no group sitting behind a desk in some office picking validators. There's no setup where some group behind a desk in an office can shut down the protocol. The beauty of Bitcoin is that there is no one to sue. There is no office to shut down. Anyone with the mining power who wants to compete in the mining space can mine Bitcoin. Right? Very democratic. Miners are a key part of the ecosystem. They're not political appointees, right? Rather, they are self-appointed volunteers. It's very different. So if a China concerned with capital flight, wanting to keep, you know, Chinese currency within the country, right? If a China decides, let's shut down an individual cryptocurrency, they wouldn't be able to shut down Bitcoin, especially not now that countries like El Salvador have adopted Bitcoin as a national currency, as legal tender. But the same can't be said for proof of stake coins. So, recently, Solana, full disclosure, I'm invested in Solana, along with several other proof-of-stake coins, right? Full disclosure, I'm involved a little bit in DeFi, right? Solana the other day had a shutdown. It wasn't the first shutdown. Understand, Solana, compared to Bitcoin, is so centralized that a centralized body can shut it down. Now, the reason why customers, consumers, are going for the proof of stake model is because it's faster, right now at least, than proof of work. You can do a Solana transaction in less than a second, much faster than you can do a Bitcoin transaction without things like the Lightning Network. But I want people to understand the cost involved and the risks inherent in working with a Solana. Right? Just understand, they're far more centralized. You have validators validating transactions. The validators theoretically could be sued, could be shut down. Right? There are far less validators on these proof-of-stake networks. Then there are miners in the proof-of-work Bitcoin ecosystem. Right, put differently, Bitcoin is much more robust, to use a Nassim Taleb word. It's much more resilient. It's harder to hack. It has had no downtime. Even luminaries in the Bitcoin space can't step out of the shadows and shut it down. The same can't be said for coins like Solana, no matter how fast it is. So let me tell you where I see things going, and just understand my mindset. I'm trying to make a profit. So if I see a profitable activity, even if I think it's not as durable as competing technologies, if on my timeline an investment is going to make money over the next 5 years or more, then okay, I'll consider investing in that technology. So as I've said numerous times here, I'm invested in many altcoins. In numerous videos, I've discussed altcoins. I've also discussed DeFi farming as well as staking. You can make a lot of money in those areas for now. But in terms of sustainability long term, in terms of a cryptocurrency that might disintermediate everything in the altcoin space, because understand, once Bitcoin, which is becoming faster because of Lightning Network and other layer 2 protocols, once Bitcoin develops its ecosystem to the point where it can have the transactional throughput of more centralized proof of stake coins, Bitcoin is going to obviate all of them. Right? Just understand, you have a coin right now that is legal tender in El Salvador. You have a coin that's legal tender in countries now. You have a coin whose usage trumps the usage of all other coins. I understand the Ethereum crowd believes there's going to be a flippening, right? But just understand, the Bitcoin brand is the strongest in the cryptoverse. More importantly, much more importantly than the brand, is the resiliency and decentralization. That's the word to focus on. Right? Because the decentralization of Bitcoin is far more advanced than any other altcoin, Bitcoin is uniquely positioned to survive a challenge from sovereign nations like China that want to shut down the cryptoverse. Folks, the horse is out of the barn. We've reached a point now where entrepreneurs, think Jack Dorsey, the CEO of Twitter and Square, are now devoting resources to help Bitcoin develop DeFi capability. Once that happens, folks, it's over. Right? People concerned with sustainability are going to realize that decentralization matters greatly. Now, right now in 2021, that's being overlooked. We've moved away from the original group that enabled Bitcoin to get a toehold in the marketplace, the group that wanted stateless money, the group that understood the risks involved, the fact that they were challenging the central banking system. As I make this video, we don't even know if Satoshi Nakamoto was a person or a group. Right? She, he, or them have backed away because they understood that this technology is revolutionary. It could topple sovereign banking systems. Right, folks? That's major. Now, what's happened since then is that people have started emphasizing and being impressed by the speed of transactions, right, by centralized competitors. The centralization, folks, as we've seen with Solana deciding, hey, we need to take our blockchain down and being able to do it. Right, think about that. You're owning a coin that can shut down the blockchain. Or think about Ethereum. Someone hacks the Ethereum blockchain and they were able to fork the chain, roll back the transaction, give people back the money they lost. Just understand, folks, that's a disaster. The entire point of cryptocurrency is that no one should have that power. The idea is that it's your keys, it's your coins. You take the risk. You do with them what you want. You can't have a further extension of the fiat monetary system where suddenly sovereign nations are announcing that they're going to freeze your assets in banks that are government regulated. So, what I want people to consider, as I continue to make YouTube videos here on coins that are centralized, right? And as I continue to discuss Bitcoin, I just want people to understand that decentralization is a must if you expect your coin to survive the upcoming battles with sovereign nations over the ability of the coin to do financial transactions. Right? It's a must. Let me also say, too, the risk of corruption is far lower when you're not relying on the credibility and integrity of politically chosen validators. So there is Bitcoin, and then there's everything else. Right? That's how you should approach your investments in cryptocurrency. Understand, Bitcoin is likely to appreciate in value because of its scarcity. That's another dynamic you need to consider, not just decentralization, not just whether the coin is proof of work, but also whether the coin has limited supply. Right? That's very important. Right, so Bitcoin likely, because of its scarcity, is likely to increase in value faster than stocks. Right, understand, of all of these coins, Bitcoin long term is the best investment. Now, that doesn't mean that I'm going to pass up profits in the intermediate term with altcoins, but you as an investor need to understand that when Bitcoin matches the transactional capability of the altcoins that are on the market, Bitcoin, because it's proof of work, because it's decentralized, because Bitcoin itself is stateless, because there aren't people behind the desk in an office who can decide whether or not to take down the protocol, exists, right? Because Bitcoin truly is decentralized, it's much more robust, much more resilient than the other coins. It has a far greater upside with a far greater chance of survival. Let me invite those of you who strongly disagree, and I understand there is an entire Ethereum 2.0 argument being made out there, right? I understand there's a Binance Smart Chain ecosystem with its own argument out there. Please feel free to use the comment section of this video to educate the viewers on your point of view. But for me, it's clear. It's clear. Bitcoin, if you had to invest in only one crypto, would be the crypto to invest in. Put differently, would you want a private group that's not answerable to voters because they're private, to have complete control over your local monetary system? Do you know the people running Ethereum well enough, if you were a country, to say, we'll accept Ethereum as legal tender? Let's say the central bank implodes or you don't have a central bank, right? El Salvador was using the dollar, by the way, before they decided to adopt the Bitcoin standard. Let's say you're a third world country and you don't have a central bank. Or let's say in the United States, the Federal Reserve gives up because people have lost confidence in the dollar because of years of dollar printing chicanery. And let's say crypto has taken over the world and you are a citizen of the United States. Would you want some private outfit, some insular private outfit, presiding over the money supply? The fact that Solana was able to take down their system should be a warning to all of us. How can you rely on money if a small group can decide to stop its use, take down the blockchain, even for the best of reasons? How could you rely on money if a small group can decide to fork the chain, undo financial transactions that have been done after a hack? Folks, in two words, you can't. That's why you need a decentralized system. Decentralized, with proof of work. That's why Bitcoin, long term, is the answer. That's how I see it. Let me hear from you. Let me also say too, there are some altcoins that are proof of work. I believe they're far more resilient, far more robust than any proof of stake coin. That's how I see it. Let me hear from you. Finally, a warning. There's scammers out there. Understand, I'll make a video on crypto and then there'll be some scammer who shows up in the comment section and who will say, hey, I know a guru who, if you give him money, he will tell you how to multiply your cryptocurrency holdings. And of course, these scams typically come with 10 or 20 thumbs up immediately. So I'll notice the scammer is posted, and before I can even get an opportunity to take the scammer's post down, I'll notice it'll have 20 thumbs up. right? To those scammers, don't waste your time. I'll be monitoring the comment section of this video. Just understand, too, that you should do your own homework. Don't rely on anyone to advise you of what's going on in the cryptoverse. I hope you use my video as just encouragement to do your own research. Nothing I said in this video should be construed as financial advice, right? Just view it as something offered for entertainment purposes only, as you do your own research about this very important subject matter. Just understand, China already has taken steps against crypto. You could imagine central banks all over are gonna fight the idea of being disintermediated by crypto. You need to understand that there will be blowback on crypto, and you need to ask yourself, which cryptocurrencies are going to survive? I'm just telling you, the centralized ones stand little chance. That's how I see it. Let me hear from you. I hope you leave your comments in the comment section of this video. Thanks for stopping by.